What does it mean that you're now part of the ten?
That I see that our spiritual fate is one shared fate. You hear? This is very, very important. I have to feel that this is it. It's one fate. I can't change it, I can't split it, I can't escape it. It's just determined from above. And so I have to accept it. The more I accept, I nullify myself, I nullify my ego with respect to spirituality. And it's the same thing. It's just given to me practically this way. If you don't feel that through your connection you're coming closer, then you're not coming closer to the Creator. Yes.
So the transition needs to be from the place where I operate for there to be results in me, to begin operating for there to be results in what we create between us, meaning in what we manage to reach in the connection inside the ten. Towards that I'm looking for the results.
You're looking for results, first of all, in feeling the ten, that it's one. That you can't differentiate from the group this and this and that separately, because you don't take into account his character or that character or his personality or something. You're taking into account the integration of the inclinations.
Also, before this excerpt, in the previous one, you said the same thing about the prayer, that if the prayer,
yes, of course,
is not from the ten, it doesn't go through the ten, then it's not a prayer for the world.
Yes, it doesn't reach the Creator, nor does it reach the world.
What is that thing of going through the ten?
Nothing exists less than ten. You understand? In spirituality, there's no less than ten.
That's clear. I just don't understand what it means that I'm going through the ten.
That if you don't nullify yourself towards the nine friends, and then beyond the concession, and then the annulment, and then the connection, and through that integration that you achieve with them, when you're already integrated, and you sense the common desire, from that, when you raise the deficiency, then your deficiency can be for the group, but the group, you already achieved it, you already attained it, and now you pray for the world. And what do you need to pray for the world? You don't ask for the world to be better, because then it's like you are your Creator is corrupting and you're fixing. You're the guardian of the world. No, you're actually asking for the whole world, that to bring him contentment.